And what brings you to this rally over here today?
Well, we are the Revolutionary Student Coordinating Committee, and we're here because inside John Jay, they're having a Board of Trustees of CUNY are having a public meeting, a public hearing. That's what they like to call it. But they actually don't make it accessible for the public, although they say they do. So in order to get into that meeting, you have to sign up, call by a certain day at a certain hour. You have to go through security, all of these things. And we've tried to get into them before, and they've actually pushed us out. We've had conversations with the police. So we decided, you know what, why not have our own Board of Trustees public hearing where students right now, some of y'all are probably CUNY. You know, CUNY is a racist institution. It's a class institution that doesn't want to let minority students actually get a chance at education. CUNY used to be a free school. You will go from free public high school to free public college. But that change came, tuition came, when CUNY started graduating the most minorities in the entire country. And they decided, let's stop that and let's put tuition as a buffer. So now you see the black and Latino enrollment rates within CUNY are dropping severely. Black and Latino students are forced to go to community colleges. To get into a four-year college is so difficult. And never mind to get into grad school, the School of Journalism, or the business school, that's absolutely impossible for a lot of black and Latino students. So we're out here trying to spread that message and trying to get students involved and let them understand that this is a racist system, this is a classist system. And our campaign is called Liberate CUNY for the People, and that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to take community control of our school and put community members on the Board of Trustees and not these Wall Street people up here that make decisions on young students of color's lives when they have no connection to us and our plight as young students in this city.
So how can people reach out? They want to get more information on what y'all doing or what y'all got planned for the future.
So you can go to Google, look up Revolutionary Student Coordinating Committee, and our WordPress should come up, and you can go on there, and our petition is on change.org. If you want to sign that digitally, you can send us an email if you want to get more involved. Currently, we have RSSC members at Queens College, John Jay College, and most colleges in CUNY, so you can get involved that way.
So what would you say to these young kids that are just entering into college? You know, what should they be aware of? And we're saying, what should they do to be able to make this a college that is not just for one ethnic group, but for all?
Well, we need to remember that education has always been fought for within CUNY. Since 1930, since before black and Latinos were even here, CUNY was free, and students fought for that during the Great Depression. They wanted to maintain the free tuition policy. They want no tuition, and then CUNY decided in the 60s, because students wanted open admissions, because the enrollment rates of black and Latino students were so low, they said, you know what, something's wrong here. So students in City College, in John Jay, in Hunter, all the colleges, almost all the colleges in CUNY during the 60s, occupied buildings. And they did the same in the 80s when tuition was being increased, because we've always known as CUNY students and students of color, we've had to fight for our education. And we're not just fighting here for ourselves, for us to graduate and get our degrees and then forget we ever went to CUNY. We're fighting for future generations. My parents went to CUNY, and a lot of these people here, their parents went to CUNY as well. CUNY has become the only option for people of color in this city to actually get an affordable education, and they're trying to take that away from us. So you need to fight for your education.
Okay, and one last message. Going to school to become a cop or police officer will not help your community. You are a black or Latino that will not ever help your community. You'll be forced to fill out these things called 250 sheets and stop and fit people of your own color, your own race.
You have 250s, right?
My uncle told me, well, so don't be a cop. That's not going to help the community. What will help the community is getting involved and fighting for education, because that will help generations to come. Becoming a cop will make you become part of this racist system. That's not what we want. We want education for all. We want an education that has no racism, an education that doesn't start with Christopher Columbus. We jump from the dinosaurs to Christopher Columbus. That's our history, and we need to change that. There were beautiful people called the indigenous people of America, the Tainos, the Arawaks, the Mayans, the Incas. They don't want to teach us that shit. They don't want to teach us about Africa, Mansa Musa, and all the empire, called Kush, and all that shit. They don't want to teach us that. So that's what we need to fight for them to teach us our history, so we can go out in our communities and make a difference, because we will know that we were made in struggles. People of color have struggled.
Well, people, as you see, that was my little niece. All right, and she's doing her thing. And give her support. You know what I'm saying? Support her and her brothers and sisters in the fight to get a better future. Because now, like she said, the tuition and even the enrollment into CUNY college for people of color has become very complicated.